Historically, it took some time to defy imperial rule, and history might be repeating itself here once more as the Fusion looked to write a new Declaration of Independence, fighting back right now against the British Hurricane.
Just gotta remind you guys, this is where everything began, it's where it's end. We are the circle of life, and we are gonna remind you guys exactly what it means to play real Overwatch. You're gonna see more Quad Tank, I have absolutely no doubt in my mind, and to be honest with you, I'm fully expecting this to go to Junkertown next.
And you call this real Overwatch, and that is a grim reality, my friend, but I do think Junkertown is where we might be going. Let's see if you're right, and it is! We're going to Australia after it got nuked. They nuked themselves.
Yeah, quite ironically leaving EU to go and show you guys how to play tanks once again. But hey, Junkertown is Hurricane's go-to map. We spoke about it earlier on in their grand final, and we were speaking about saying they're not really the team that goes to something like Dorado. They will always pick Junkertown if they have the option, I suppose you could say. And in this case, they've got the option. They lost the last map. It's all a ruse, my friend. They gave that last map to Fusion so they could show them just how to play Junkertown.
Oh, really? So the entire thing was to give false confidence, where you want to...
Absolutely. You guys live off your hopes and dreams. We've got to give you something to ride on, right?
Well, you know what? I think our hopes and dreams have somewhere to go here. Might be a little bit of underestimation, or maybe this is wishful thinking on my part, because let me tell you, reverse sweeps don't happen all that often. And yet, the same note, the Fusion do have an uncanny attachment to the number 5.
They do. I believe they were one of the teams that went 3-2 through pretty much most of the regular season, giving you guys a real good show every single time it came around to casting them. Maybe they're in for the same thing here. Maybe they're the ones who have been holding back since the very, very start, just to say, let's give the Europeans a bit of hope, and then we'll show them exactly how we play dive here in NA.
You know what? I can get on board that story. I think for once, I absolutely agree with you. Well played, sir.
I'm glad that you didn't see the lies behind my eyes that time either.
Oh, I just purposely didn't. I wasn't even looking you in the eye. That's where we're at right now. I remember a time where I could look you in the eye, but not anymore.
Not after today.
Oh.
We'll go and sit in that room. So, like, Junkrat exists, right? That was your saying all weekend. Junkrat exists. Do these teams know that Junkrat exists? And we said to you, well, don't you think EU teams have tried this? And they did for a week or two until they realized, actually, Junkrat isn't the be-all and end-all answer to tank-based compositions.
Well, the interesting thing, of course, that was the teams that said it. Every NA team came in and said, Junkrat exists! But Junkrat does not exist right now. Fusion has not really trended towards playing him. Of course, I don't think it's Zachary's favorite hero in the world. Meanwhile, what is this?
Magic, my friend. We're about to enlighten you to another style of play that you have not yet seen. I can just envision all of you guys on the plane on the way back just rocking, sucking your thumbs back and forth. Junkrat exists. Junkrat exists. Junkrat exists. That is going to be your motto for life, or at least until the next scene of Contender starts, and then you see Quad Tank is a thing.
I mean, to a degree, but also, they're not running Junkrats. There is a plan here.
They need you to coach them. You need to go out there and say, guys, we've got to take this seriously now. Our pride is on the line. It's time to go for Junkrat. But you know what? Even they are hopping on this final crazy ride. They're going for it themselves.
You know what? A victory is a victory.
How does this make you feel?
It makes me feel somewhat dirty. It makes me feel unclean. I'm not sure there's a shower strong enough here to wash that away, but worry about those implications later as Fusion University is coming out with a quad tank of their own. And there goes right in!
They're doing it! They're doing the EU strategy of piling in and trying to murder everyone! Kragi is still alive for the time being, but the health bar is below 100. He's about to get popped out, but it's got to be.
And you just see a D.Va looking at face going, hiya! But the defensive matrix eventually falls. Kragi laying in the damage. The Bastion was ready. The meat keeps on falling. Fusion University did not study well in their quad tank class.
They absolutely did not. Clearly, they were the ones going on a bit of a roam around during lesson time, you might say, not reading up on their study notes. In this case, you've got to say, for any team from EU, they play against a lot of quad tanks. They've got answers to this kind of thing. And so far, it's in the form of a Bastion with that tank formation.
This is how democracy dies, not with the dream, but with a meme. That's what we might be looking at here as the Hurricane very tightly packed around this Bastion.
New policy. Hurricane is president. We'll say Shifty the coaches. Every team must play quad tank. Let's see how they can make this work.
They're healing up Kragi as the beam of healing behind him moves into tank. Just pummels Zachary with one shell to the face. And the artillery ride not stopping yet. Four kills for the Hurricane. And they blow the Fusion away.
Oh, what can I say? That's definitely one way with dealing with what Fusion were throwing at them. And they did switch off of that quad tank pretty immediately back over to the more comfortable full dive, which we've seen coming out of these guys time and time again. I'm dead curious to see how long British Hurricane choose to stay by this pirate ship as Captain Kragi is at the helm.
Captain Kragi, known for running a tight ship, quite literally, very much likes his entire crew around him at all times. The buddy system well in play. However, a self-destruct here, if aimed well with a little bit of tank disruption, can work, but it would have to be very well because shields are protecting on all ends.
Here they are from above. It's not they actually have to dive in at all here as well. They're going to jump straight in, but the shadow comes out and Fusions catches everyone. This could be a real melting.
Well, you knock him down and Craggy finishes the job. A great Earth Shatter in from Fusions. This is looking dire for Fusion University. I don't think they took a class in dealing with Omnic Crisis 2.0.
Definitely a crisis of a new variety, it feels, with the Orisa at the helm, with the Bastion following in. The only thing they feel like they're missing really here is the Zen, but they want all that focus healing coming out of the Mercy. They've even got the Valkyrie online, and every single member of Hurricane is on fire right now, bar Crusade, but you can see exactly how this is going.
Early barrier out here for Fusion University, trying to derail the ship, trying to send it to the Abyss, and with Bok down early, it's looking good, but Craggy, not able to get into the tank. Elk has had enough. Takes him down, the power of sound. Who are you gonna dash on through? At Fusion University, finally put an end to the piracy in our time. Ready to be
unleashed. Clamp down, follow the law, they say, as they come down hard on these miscreants. And British Hurricane look like they're gonna switch off now as well. Get Kib going across to the Genji. They'll try and match the competition coming out of Fusion. I gotta say, that hasn't worked out too well historically, but I'm willing to give it a chance.
Well, this is a good change of momentum here for Fusion because British Hurricane, they had to sacrifice most of their ult building to do this full swap up. So this next fight, much more likely to go well in their favor as who are you? Dives on in. The blade is out. He knows how much he can deal with it. But oh, Kib takes him out on the flip side. Who are you? Might have gotten a little bit too deep. An opportunity for British Hurricane, even as they're very, very low. Fusion was able to finish them off. They lost Beast Halo. And suddenly, momentum swapped the other day. The Hurricane was so close to dead, and yet they're not.
Quite surprised you haven't seen any Widow play coming out of both sides. In fact, the EU guys are coming across to try and match Fusion and say, hey, we'll play your style of play. We'll give you a chance in this one, and we'll see how you fare up against our dive. And it feels like here on Junkertown, ideally enough, the British Hurricane home, they are showing them how to play.
And they're just going to keep this ride on going. And if it's a last ride, it is a good one. 4 minutes and 9 seconds left for the Hurricane. Plenty of time to work with here in Junkertown.
Elk gonna switch across to the Ana now as well. Those longer sight ranges coming through on the third and final point of Junkertown. Definitely very beneficial to playing on the Ana, but Bok for now is gonna stick it out on the Zen. They need that Discord orb to burn through the tanks of Fusion University.
Hurricane looking to continue their momentum here. Fusion University doesn't have too much to work with, but they can just buy a little bit of time for Alarm and move in with the Transcend. That's likely the play they're looking for here. Zachary, no chill whatsoever, looking for Zen in the back. Can't finish the job. Ends up having the rewind, but Kip down. Spike back and forth, but Bok, he's gonna heal back up. The fact that the kill wasn't finished could be big because now he can come in with a Transcend of his own. Alarm gonna use his Transcendence first, but now look to Bok. Does he invest? He does! Both Senyals gonna pass into the Iris. This could be good for Fusion here because British Hurricane, I'm not sure if they're ready to set up. Here comes Kib though, played out to the other side. Does he have targets here inside? No, he does not. He ends up falling to who are you?
Fusion University managed to distract them and still keep hold of several ultimates. They've even got that Nano Blade combo if they wish to make use of Beast Halo goes down. This is the time for who are you to pull out that blaze?
Lay it out. Who are you? Going, I'm Tank Hunting. Slices through a scientist with a side of Korean War Mech, but can't chase it down. Not fishing his plate. Not the heaviest eater as it turns out. The Hurricane gonna get some payload progress as a result.
It's a bit weird because Beast Halo died once again with that primal range. It seems to be becoming a recurring theme throughout this series. We've seen it happen quite a few times now. But Zachary managed to pick up Kibbis. He goes a little bit too deep, and this might just reset Hurricane once again.
Elk again with the beautiful Bionade to the other side. 4 kills for the Fusion University, and they will hold the Hurricane back. Maybe did a little bit of storm prep this time around.
Seems they came with their raincoats and their umbrellas ready to deal with whatever the Hurricane are going to be throwing at them. It does feel for the Hurricane they're trying to match what Fusion University are throwing at them, and we have to concede it feels they may have a little bit of a better grasp on what's going on in this whole dive setup, but so much of that it feels like goes down to Elk on the Ana. This guy is a machine.
And he didn't always play it this early season. I mean, he was always good, but here on live, he's been great. Meanwhile, Zachary under assault here, 52 HP. Gonna go back, heal on up. Meanwhile, Crusade a little bit deep. Beast Halo punches him. We're just walking Zachary's adventure here. He's on a ride. Meanwhile, Fusion winning the fight on the other side. Finally, the end destination. A little bit of a stick to Fusion's to end the fight.
They keep on getting into the bat line here, and it feels like Hurricane aren't necessarily quick enough to adapt and deal with the aggression coming out of Fusion University. Zachary definitely showing up as well. There's been a lot of talk around who are you and Alarm, but this guy is on fire alongside the likes of Elk. You can really see this team showing what they're made of here.
Meanwhile, Fusion, they've been able to restabilize. To your point, you look at them here, almost every ult about to be up. You have a blade from who are you, you got the Transcend from Alarm, first Hurricane. They're pushing the objective now, but you see Beast Hell going off the side, but he's under assault here, has the Primal Rage early. That's a good get, but Bok is already down.
Still trying to find their way back into this point, and Elk has got such a beautiful long sight range here as well. Might have to use the nano boost onto someone to make sure they can hold this point out as Hurricane Fusions has invested that primal rage, but is so close to going down. But we're looking towards that transcendence, which does not get pulled out to keep him alive, and there is 60 seconds.
Oh, he got the sleep! He tagged him in the back! What a play by Elk! Beast Halo stomps him on right over. We just saw a little bit about that, but that was fantastic. 45 seconds left out in the map.
They've even got the Blade and available, they've got the Transcendence, they've got the Nano Boost, they've got essentially everything except for the Primal Rage on Beast Halo. But Hurricane equally have been stockpiling their own War Chest. They have four ultimates to bring out. They will not have either of the Primal Rages available just yet in this fight, but it may turn out to be there in the latter stages.
Elk holding in the back, and now he's going to have to use Snap Boost. Zachary's down early, you got Compensate, it goes to where you? That's the way Compensate, a Nano Blade moving on in with a little bit of explosion on the side. Now, when Senyata beats a Genji, and Who Are You goes in, and it's Kip over the top. Gets Who Are You in time, but the push still very disrupted here for the Hurricane.
Yeah, Dracolak is about to run out of his mech as well, so he won't have that available in this fight if he gets picked off. This might actually be Hurricane turning this one around.
Hurricane desperately fighting here. Both teams moving in, and Fusion still in the mode of stabilization. Hurricane pushing it over, but they have everyone up. They can contest this one last time. And here's the Blade on the other end. Kip moving on in, gets Elk, gets rid of the threat, no sleep dart this time, as the Hurricane look to make this fight their own. Kip with a really nice Blade to start off, three kills to his name, and the Hurricane finish it off at the very end.
Well, there we go. Now we know what's expected of Fusion Universe. They need to complete to be able to match Hurricane and force this into another round and bring us towards that fabled fifth map. Got to say, ZP at halftime definitely didn't look like we were going to go all the way to that fifth map. But with how Fusion have definitely stepped up and started to bring the pain to Hurricane, things are looking a lot closer.
I like to think that Papa Jeff at some point donned a wizard hat and just cast a curse on Fusion and said, never will you win a series unless it goes to five. You will be forever linked with the number five. It was a big involved ritual, and look, this might be the reality.
Are you present for the ritual? Did you have to donate some of your blood to it, maybe? Just to say it's even the caster curse now. Maybe it's only when you cast them this happens.
I don't want to talk about all the things I had to donate there. I might be down a kidney right now. Why do I do that? I have no idea. I mean, it just said, do you want to be involved in this cool thing this Saturday? Yeah, let's go.
And then you don't remember anything else?
No.
One thing you might remember is if we do get to that fifth map, if Fusion take it away and go back home with the, should we call it the unofficial crown of best team in contenders?
I think absolutely. I think right now Fusion has definitely woken up. Maybe there was something to the idea perhaps early on where they were getting off of that high where they had won everything and then had to come back up. But we've seen the level play from Fusion certainly rise up as the series has gone on.
I would love to see here Fusion University really live up to their namesake and be treating life itself as a lesson. Because as it stands, they are essentially mimicking the comp we saw just a second ago out of British Hurricane for that first point. But you know what? Hurricane are matching it like for like. They're bringing out their own Bastion on defense with Kier playing on the Orisa.
What a world we live in. Bastion in 2018. Junkertown never change.
They are clearly taking the word tank a little bit too seriously here when they're picking up this Bastion. It's not quite a quad tank, but it is a tank of its own once it transforms into that tank formation.
Look, thematical correctness is still totally fine. You don't have to take everything at literal face value. It's fine.
Well, let's see how they choose to opt this one out. Curious to see what Who Are You will change away to, or if they'll just stick out this hand zone and they try and go for some combos. I expect it to switch away to try and join in with this all-in on the Bastion setup they've opted for so far. And Hurricane have got themselves definitely fortified in here on this high ground.
And they're just sort of taunting Fusion, going, yeah, get back on your cute little ship. We have the cannons here docked portside. See if you can move on in as Craggy letting loose here with that Bastion fire. Gonna reload here in a second, but Beast Halo taking an awful lot of damage there in the moment. We'll see if he can get healed up, but Fusion University, they're having trouble leaving port.
Still trying to get hold of Zachary as well. It's not the two Bastions trying to face up and find each other. It looks like Zachary's going to get melted down, and Craggy will win this and brings out the tank formation.
Early tank coming up. Zachary might be back in play, but he might wish he wasn't. Staring down the barrel of a tank as Craggy continues to lay it on. Meanwhile, you had a dragon out from Who Are You, a very early dragon, but doesn't do too much as Craggy gets on the other team's payload. Oh, yeah, you earned the right to taunt.
There's no passive healing options available, I'm afraid, Craggy, but it's still definitely sending a message.
Oh, no.
They're saying, we want this, and Who Are You is all alone at the back.
Battle Bastion versus Hanzo. Hanzo, you don't have your buffs yet. Meanwhile, the Coalescence on the other side just melts down Zachary. The Hurricane playing this Bastion comp way better. Fusion probably about to swap.
All about the dive. It seems to be the go-to answer for Fusion every time they want to win. Kind of say if you're trying to balance up the sort of number of comps we have in the game and who can play them better, it feels like we're slightly in the lead here, ZP.
Right now, the Hurricane are showing great versatility, and the Fusion, in their attempts to mimic it, didn't quite work out as Zachary almost gets deleted by Hafakul. Gonna have to rewind out under pressure, but it buys time for Beast Tail and Horyu, who dive on into the Smash, and Horyu's immediately dispatched. Didn't work out.
Just spray and hope for the best. It seems to be the answer when everyone is clowning in front of you, just trying to hide you away between those large tank models in the game. And then Fraggy goes super low, finally gets himself dropped.
Payload has been with this entire time. Zachary just slowly pushing it, you know, panting as he goes. Fraggy brought back up there for quick death. Who are you back into the fray? Dashing in, game play, dashing out. Oh, the style on the other side! Gets Craggy with that soft touch pulse bomb. Zachary making the way, pushes the payload, he kills the Bastion, and he flanks the tanks. Let's go!
With no Bastion, there is no big damage coming out of the side of Hurricane here. They might find themselves pushed back.
Oh!
Great dodge for the Shudder!
Zachary actually just channeling Ultra Instinct right now, dodging everything. His hair has gone white.
He's definitely popping off, and that's what you want to be able to pull your team through to at least the first point. He's even getting the backline 3 HP and still manages to make it away.
Gets the stick on the other end. This is one of the best rounds of Tracer, like best minute of Tracer you could ask for. What a play by Zachary. Gonna do a little bit more. Fusion looking to point B.
And they finally get themselves there. Would have been a shame if it ended at that first point there, not able to breach through this Bastion setup coming out of Hurricane, but they equally are going to change things back up. They're going back over to Sunbracer.
All right, change-ups are in play. Fusion still alive, a long way to go for this payload, 3 minutes and 20 seconds through second. Zachary, we look to him right now as he has been playing out of his mind. Crackwacken though, Dean back to not much you can do about that. Fusion gonna take a little bit of retreat, a reprieve to the payload.
Hover his way back over, and this is where we start to see the real metal of Fusion being tested, is can they push through the second point now that Hurricane has changed it up. It's like a gauntlet where you have a different obstacle to face every single time in the form of a different comp, and so far, they are making it work.
Who are you dashing out of the rafters, gets Crusade as Beast Halo goes ape into the back lines, gets a triple kill. Beast Halo coming in style, set up by the rest of his team.
Hurricane getting wiped out there, giving Fusion a lot of time to push forward. They've even got the Transcendence on alarms. They could go for that aggressive transit they wanted to here and force their way into the bat line of Hurricane, whereas they don't really have anything to stop this yet. Kib is getting closer to that EMP, but it won't be available at the start of this fight to really shut down University before they get rolling.
Fusion, plenty of uncontested payload here. Riz Hurricane will have that one attempt. They're gonna move in with the Valkyrie. The self-destruct Topia gets one, and it does! It gets Elk! No more valuable person to get off the self-destruct, but Fusion's was too deep. Alarm counters of the Transcend, and a little bit of boom of their own comes in from Fusion as they take the fight right back, and it doesn't matter that they lost Elk. The rest of the team still very powerful in the moment. Hafakul almost getting demacked, and now he is. Pulse bomb out, finishes him off as Zachary is in play once more.
Zachary is popping off on this Tracer, and to be honest with you, you think of Tracer plays, he's not a name I think of, but definitely showing that he should be considered. And who are you reminding us just what he can do with Genji tearing through most of Hurricane, but there are kills being traded back and forth to each side.
He might be active, but he doesn't care. He goes, I can still throw shurikens. This is totally fine. Already at another 21%. Point B has been taken. 3 minutes left for Fusion to bring this to the end.
Can Hurricane hold on here and delay Fusion University, or will we find ourselves going into the overtime and that fabled fifth map?
That would be destiny. That has been Fusion's destiny all contenders long. Why would we change now?
Living the American dream, you might say, in some cases, ZP, but now they find themselves pushing in towards that first corner. That's when we're going to start being the real contest coming through. Who are you gets hacked? He's incredibly low, but is kept alive by his team.
Zachary with that early pickoff sets the stage for Fusion here, looking for more. Get one support, but why not pick up the pair? On the block right now, needs one more clip, gets him down. And hey, who's gonna be your lifeline, British Hurricane? Because Zachary has shut him down.
Trying to find the way into this one, but it feels for Hurricane, like you say, they're being hard shut down by University, just showing their prowess on these dive phase compositions, and Hurricane really struggling to find their feet so far.
Hurricane has been off target ever since the very beginning. Another pulse bomb by Zachary, not quite going to connect this time, but look at all the progress Fusion has gotten. They're one fight away.
And with 2 minutes on the clock, it feels like it could be their time. Boxcott holds that Transcendence, so they have the defensive capabilities if required. But Who Are You has just got that blade online, and Elk is getting very close to that nano boost.
Who Are You with the blade early, slices through the tanks. Transcend gonna ruin his day a little bit. He has to wait. Doesn't go over the pulse bomb, just waiting and waiting, but now he gets to go in. Look to fish out the baby diva, dives to the supports, Lucio into sight, and the dive continues to move in from Fusion as the Hurricane is getting blown back.
Nano boosted Tracer, not one of the things I thought I would have seen today, but with how Zachary is performing, I do not blame them at all. They've only got a few minutes to go. Fusion might beat out Hurricane here on Junkertown, their own map.
Zachary not going to cut that pulse bomb, but still has Bakken to sights. Bakken to fall. Beast Halo finishing off the tanks of Fusion, smothering the Hurricane here. A minute 12 left, and they're going to have a vastly superior time bank as we go into extra rounds.
We've got to see something special come out of British Hurricane here. I don't want to say it's going to be quad tank. It might be Bastion once again. Just something to hold Fusion at bay because they've got a lot more time in the bank than what Hurricane do on this push. But first and foremost, let's see exactly how Hurricane can make this work, what their answer is on their push. First time round, it went pretty smoothly. It looks like they're going to opt maybe once again for the Bastion, bring it out to the fore, and we saw what that could do last time. It could do quite a lot.
This is a little bit risky, though. I feel like these strategies do not quite have a shelf life that goes beyond one push. Fusion has a better idea of what to expect here and what went wrong the first time. And in fact, they know, British Hurricane knows that Fusion knows, and they might not be trying to go to that same well again.
Possibly. I would like to see them run with Elk on this Ana because we've seen huge biotic grenades out of this guy today. And the best way to shut down a Bastion is once those shields are down, you just slip in a cheeky little biotic grenade, the healing is denied, and he disappears incredibly quickly despite that 300 HP.
That might be just what they're looking for here. And of course, you take a look at the British Hurricane setup, they are going to be going a little bit more standard where it's still going to be very tank heavy. They'll put half a cool on Hanzo, one of his flex heroes that has been good on the DPS end. Meanwhile, for Fusion University, that's a May.
It's a May. We spoke to a number of teams over the last few days and said, is there any surprises that you've got up your sleeves? The things that you're going to maybe bring out, we won't reveal just yet, but I feel quite safe in saying this. A number of them said May was a consideration for some of their DPS picks. We saw it on Horizon Luna Colony in the final earlier today.
And look, with Zachary's apparent ability to see the future, as we saw in the beginning of the last map, maybe he can make this May work. Not the easiest thing to do here, but you're not expecting to get frozen out. This wall can split a team and work against the Bastion here. When the Bastion is up, the dive is coming in, and they got the sleep early on and put the Orisa up. They almost knocked down the Orisa off that wall. That was incredible, but did not quite work out. However, Crusade is down. Elk is more DPS than healer here, but it's Hafakul and Fraggy. Well protected, bowing down Fusion. They almost stopped it, but it's almost is not enough.
Almost, despite both healers going down, Craggy is still managed to stay on the point here, and they are pushing in towards this first point. If they manage to get them, they are in such a great advantage. Zachary is gone. This is going to be Fusion on the stagger, and they can make this work. Craggy is super close to this tank formation, too.
3 seconds left. The second point well inside. Zachary going to stick on the bank.
See if they can push in towards this one. You know there's going to be a contest here, because Fusion know if they stop them here, then it's going to be so difficult for them to push and get through on towards that second point. Otherwise, they're in for a world of hurt. Here comes the tank formation once again.
Tank looking for alarm, takes him right out, right on the side. Oh my goodness.
Oh, give up.
He's a man, he's fighting the tank, and he gets up! Oh my god! I don't care if he died there, that was the essence of Worth.
Craig is going to be sitting here now saying, it's not Alarm I've got to worry about. That's what he said to us in the interviews. Now I'm worried about Elk. These supports on Fusion University are insane.
Who would have thought that a tank would fear a 60-year-old woman just running at it? Just Hunter is like, I got you. And it did. But you look at Zachary. Winter is coming. The Blizzard is up. He's looking to just drop this on top of them. Waiting. Patience is important. Drops the wall, brings them on the top. That's how you isolate the Bastion here. Craggy, frozen on out. The self-destruct, though, isolates who are you. There's the Blizzard. This is so smart from Zachary here, and it works out. But for how long?
Not long, it would appear, as they're starting to lose members, but Beast Halo brings down Fusions. They have the res available to bring him back in, but it looks like Alarm's Transcendence is going to be the call to action for Fusion University.
Bio nade to the back, your healing's gone. Beast Halo coming back on the other side, looking to finish off Orisa. Here's he going to do it. Kim, still alive. Moira came in last moment, but no, it's not enough. The Blade sweeping its way through overtime, likely to end right here.
Absolutely. Well, it ticks down and a very valiant effort coming out of the Hurricane, but now we get to see what Fusion University can do. Can Hurricane hold them on that first point like they did for so long with the Bastion set up last time, or do we see them push all the way through and take us into that map 5?
I think no matter what, this is going to end in overtime. That went long enough that even with the time bank advantage, it doesn't amount to that much aside from being a little bit of buffer for a rough start. Either way, this is going to end in overtime at this point. either a victory for the Fusion, and thus a map 5 for which it seems nothing but destined, or the Hurricane taking the title for EU.
Taking the title of one last ride, because they're rocking out with this quad tank once again. It's been Bastion pretty much all maps so far, but this time they're saying if this really is our last defense, we want to do it the EU way, and they're going to bring out that fabled setup. Kib once again on the Roadhog. We saw Craggy playing it a little bit earlier on, and now they're going back to the boy himself, who was landing so many great hooks on Ilios.
Attackers incoming.
Why wouldn't you go back to this? Seconds. Fusion so far has had a real difficulty actually dealing with this in the moment, and thus the Hurricane. They're going to go to the well once more.
I'm curious to see how this stacks up, because we spoke quite a lot, especially before the broadcast. We've had a bit of banter back and forth all weekend between all the casters sat outside in one of the other rooms. And we've been saying for the longest time, Quad Tank, it does not stack up against this level of dive. And there's been a kind of a bit of a mix throughout this game so far, throughout the series, where in some cases it's won, in some cases it's lost. This is the final one potentially that matters in this final fight on Junkertown.
And you hear the crowd, they're pumped. They want this to be a Hurricane defense here. We'll see if that's going to be the case as a Fusion now. Look to move on in, and oh, sneakiness in and around the side. Here come the tanks. Who says tanks can't dive? But Hapical eating a whole lot of damage early on. The D-Mech comes on in, and it's Trades. But Trades, quite good for the offense in this position. They're going to be able to run back over. Elk was able to retreat to a very safe position in the back, and Kip is getting flanked on all ends as the Hurricane try and back up and restabilize. They might do just that.
Very dangerous to just sit in front of the spawn doors, because essentially you can have the enemy shooting at you from within them. But they're still fighting this close. They're trying to go for the full hold, again, to burn that clock down as best they can.
And Fusion, they're trying to evict the quad tanks here while still pushing the payload. You see Zachary isn't participating in the fight as much as he would, because his goal here is get the payload forward. Make the fight change, but he gets caught by a stray fire strike. Hurricane making the stand pretty good, but now who are you with momentum? Dash resets, a blade, and cleanup on the way as Elk sets the stage. Who are you? Knocks it right down.
Going huge, Elk and Who Are You coming together to show us what they're made of. 1 minute left on the clock, they finally break that full hold, and they are on the way towards this point. But Craggy has got hold of that Graviton Surge. There is almost signs of that Earth Shadow coming online as well. They have the tools to hold them here, but they've got to do it for 45 seconds.
What cleanup there, where you get the Biomade set up, and Who Are You goes, yeah, I'm going to dash back in. But the fight underway right now, the EMP coming out here. In the moment, no, not an EMP, but you see Who Are You down early on, and the self-destruct on the top, Cracklackin trying to make a little bit of room, and the fight engagement not quite as good for Fusion here in the moment, as the Hurricane able to re-solidify here. And the University, they're down there for 15 seconds, the Hurricane on the verge of the EU Championship.
They've got the stagger underway as well. Beast Taylor went down there with 15 seconds on the clock. He will be late to this next fight. He's late to his own graduation. This is an even bigger stagger. The grab surge is huge. It brings down Alarm. It brings down Who Are You. Hurricane may have done it here.
They might have done it, and they
yes,
did!
They have.
That is excitement coming from you, Dez, but well deserved. The Hurricane take the bragging rights between the regions. They win here.